Hey there, folks, and welcome back to another episode of Quarantine Quiz Time, the game show from my home where the contestants don't gotta leave their home. Please welcome today's contestants, Isabel and Elisa. Now, Isabel, please tell the audience a bit about yourself.
Hello, everyone. I am Isabel Drew. I'm from Sudbury originally, and I'm living in St. Catharines. Doing my own thing, learned sewing recently.
What kind of garments have you made?
Making a bunch of masks right now, out of old clothes, pretty much is what I've been working with. So yeah, mainly just masks. Like, I learned to sew, and then I learned how to make masks.
Elisa, can you tell the audience a bit about yourself?
My name is Elisa Vanecki. I'm a Brazilian filmmaker living in Canada, and I just shot my short film, Valerie.
Now, have you ever just woken up and done nothing but procrastinate all day? For the uneducated, procrastinating is the act of doing nothing but duking all day whilst also shirking one's responsibilities. But in these trying times, that's actually an achievement in and of itself. You know, doing mundane things like chores around the house is kind of a measurement now of how successful our day was during quarantine. Now, with that being said, our first game is Did You Human Today? Now, contestants, I have a list of questions I'm going to ask you to make sure you're at least lifting a finger. For everything you have done today, I'll give you a point. For everything you haven't done, well, can't really blame you, but, you know, it's still not getting that you point. Too bad, so sad. Are we ready?
Okay.
Got it?
Yes,
okay.
I am ready.
Did you get out of bed?
Today?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Elisa, did you get out of bed at all today? Even a little?
Yes, I did.
Did you brush your teeth?
Yes.
Both of you did?
I did, in fact. And I flossed as well. So I don't know if there's brownie points for that.
Oh. You know what? Yeah, let's do that. Brownie points. Elisa, did you floss?
Oh, yes. My father is a dentist, so yeah.
Yeah, Isabel, you couldn't really get in the lead there, unfortunately. Did you shower? And don't lie, because I can smell you guys through the phone.
I did.
Okay.
I did not.
Okay.
Do we get, like, subtractions for how many days we haven't showered for?
Did you have a bowel movement? That's something I don't really want to smell through the phone.
Most definitely. Yeah, as soon as I wake up in the morning.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Did you do the dishes?
I literally did it half an hour ago, so.
I did.
Oh. Did you check your emails?
Yes.
Yes.
Did you change your underwear from the previous day?
Yes, I took a shower.
Okay.
What if you don't wear underwear?
I didn't really consider that.
No.
Did you change your pants?
Yeah, I definitely changed pants,
okay,
for sure.
We'll count that.
Like, okay, yeah, I was in, like, bathing suit today as well, so.
Nice try. We're not awarding any extra points based on how many outfits you've changed into today. Did you take out the garbage?
No.
Does compost count?
I mean, I guess it would. It's near a garbage. Yeah, we'll count it. Elisa, did you compost, recycle, and or garbage at all today?
No.
Oh. Well, did you guys vacuum any garbage? Did you vacuum?
Vacuum?
Like, I cleaned the house yesterday, not today.
Did you exercise? I'm exercising right now. You just can't see my lower half.
Yes, I did.
Oh,
I'm ashamed of myself.
2 points behind. I think we just caught a contestant on a rest day. Although during quarantine, I think every day is a rest day. Did you put on a pair of the same color socks? Not different, the same.
No. Definitely not.
Okay. And finally, did you tell someone you care for them?
Yes,
100%. Yep, absolutely.
That's what we need during this pandemic. A little bit of love. The score right now is Isabel 10, Elisa 8. Elisa, you gotta get ahead a little bit. Now for our next game, I hope you have your soap and vocal cords ready. And no, this is not a dish soap chugging challenge. I think we've all evolved a little bit since the days of the Tide Pod challenge. No, our next game is hand wash karaoke. Contestants, I'll need you to get to your nearest and dearest hand wash stations. You'll each have to pick a song to sing while you wash your hands for 20 seconds as outlined by the Government of Canada. Whoever has the best performance wins. You can get boa constrictors like Britney at that one VMAs. Get creative, this is your moment, guys!
I have a technical issue here. I can't unplug my laptop. So...
Can you do the action of hand washing?
I absolutely can.
Can you be thorough? Can you get under the nails and everything?
I could, you know what, too? I could even get a bowl with water if we wanted to go that far. I could, like, set something up.
Now, Elisa, are you able to get to a sink?
Yes, I am.
Okay, we're gonna ask you to please head to the sink now.
Are you gonna time it, or do we time it?
Whenever you're ready, I will start the Mississippis.
Okay, go.
Okay, Elisa, are you ready? Isabel, are you okay with going first?
Yes.
Okay, whenever you're ready, and I'll start the Mississippis.
Okay, ready?
Ready, set, go!
Okay,
you got in the groove. round of applause. Contestant number one, phenomenal.
Now, you washed your hands for the last 5 seconds there, though, that's correct?
I know, I got distracted with my music and my other performing intentions.
Well, you incorporated only like a little bit of actual hand washing, but for creativity, the roof was blown.
Elisa. Isabel got in the groove there. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm just gonna play my song first.
Okay. Je suis avec ma go enfouraillé au cas où faudrait simplifier quand tu pilotes un prototype pour assumer. Elle est tellement douce, obligée de faire dans la durée. Avec elle, c'est le marathon. Avec elle, pas de baratin. Bang, bang, bang. Si tu traînes dans un baratin.
Hey, that was really good. You know, your hands move like feet.
You know, you dance with your hands. You had contestant number one dancing.
I'm gonna have to give this round to you. Congratulations.
Yay!
Now, Isabel, I know you couldn't get your electronics in the bathroom, so I don't know the ethics of if that's fair or not. So, I'm gonna award you a little bonus points. I'm gonna give you a point and a half. I'm gonna give you 1.5 points. Yeah.
That's not fair. Why you gave 1.5 for her?
Because Isabel didn't have a sink. Is that fair? Okay, you know what? This is my game show, okay? So, you know what? You guys are both tied. Let's make it a little bit dramatic. Now, contestants, unfortunately, the film industry is not really an essential business. So, I don't know about you, but I think I've watched everything on Netflix at least 5 times by now.
We're running out of content.
We need to make sure people don't get COVID and boredom. So, this next game is called YouTube. Contestants, I'm going to give you a minute of prep time. When the 60 seconds are up, the one who can pitch me the best new TV show idea in 1 minute wins. Are you ready?
I already have one.
If we're ready, I don't know.
Okay, Elisa, let's have you go first this time. What is your idea for a series?
Following the life of a Formula One car pilot, the love of his life, and how they get in love. In the end, it shows the relationship between the girl and her mother, and she has like an instability, a mental health issue, and the guy, he becomes an alcoholic because of family problems. One of these days, he went down to have a drink with one of his friends, and the wife is pregnant, and then he crashes the car, and he goes pick up the wife. Crashes the car with her, but the baby is still alive, and now the series will follow him taking care of the young girl.
Did you just rehash the plot to Ricky Bobby? Sons of bitches.
No.
You know what? That was a lot of detail. Very thorough. Maximum pointage. Okay, Elizabeth, let's see what you got. Elizabeth, why did I say Elizabeth?
Okay, mine's like more of like a game show, funny, lighthearted approach. And it's like, there's one contestant, and then the directors, they pick like someone in their life. And there's like a box, and in the box, it's either something that is like either like one of their worst fears, or it's like a money cash reward or whatever. And they could pick like the person who picks it is like could be like an ex or like a family member, and then you kind of get all the drama.
Okay, you know what? I could definitely see that show on Fox. It's right up there with shows like Joe Millionaire. Elisa, yours is great. I've seen many dramas like yours. You know, it's up there with This Is Us. But Isabel, you know, your idea, I've seen variations of it, but not really that particular one. It's unique. So I think I'm gonna have to give it to Isabel. I'm gonna have to give the win to her.
She
is at 14 and a half.
Damn!
Elisa, you are 11 and a half. Now, let's go down the prize hole! Elisa, for being runner-up, you'll receive this vial of hand sanitizer. Paint your nails with it, drink it, don't actually drink it, do all you can to protect yourself this pandemic. Our grand prize winner, Isabel, will receive this mini fridge. Stock up on food so you leave the house less, overconsume carbs, and slurp up that sodium. So congratulations, audience, round of applause.
Thank you!
Take your final bow. Thank you for participating in tonight's episode of Quarantine Quiz Time. Thank you, players at home, for playing along. If you're interested in being the next contestants on Quarantine Quiz Time, please don't hesitate to contact me on one of the following socials. Until next time, you've been watching Quarantine Quiz Time, where double the chins means double the fun. Good night, everybody!